So the Ten Commandments, God gave the Ten Commandments, and he gave the Ten Commandments to show us what was right and wrong. And in our hearts witness to the Ten Commandments. And one of the commandments is, you shall have no other gods before me. And we make idols in our hearts. We make our car a god. We make our pension a god. We make money a god. And these become idols in our hearts. They become idols in our hearts. And we worship them. We honor them. We give them glory rather than the living God glory. We give them honor. We honor our car. We honor our house. We honor everything but him. And it says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. And our hearts worship the car, they worship the pension, they worship the wife, they worship many, many things, but they don't worship the living God. And the Bible says that we're guilty. The Bible says that we're guilty before God. The Bible says that we're guilty before the living God. And when we become guilty, how do we get rid of that guilt? Jesus says in the Bible, Jesus says, there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. That there'll be a judgment day. That there'll be a judgment day. And that there is a hell. And hell is a place where the guilty go. And are you and I guilty if we break the Ten Commandments? If it says in the Bible, thou shalt not steal, and you steal, are you guilty or not? If the Bible says, thou shalt not lie, and you lie, are you guilty or not? Are you guilty if you break the Ten Commandments? And the Bible says that all fall short of the glory of God. All of us fall short of the glory of God. Every single one of us. And we become guilty. Now, how do we get rid of that guilt? If you lie, what does that make you? If you lie, what does that make you? If you steal, what does that make you? If you curse the name of God and curse his name, what does that make you? What does it make you? It means that we are under his judgment. And if we're under his judgment, then we need his forgiveness. We need his forgiveness. And that's what you need today. You need his forgiveness. And Jesus paid that price for you, but you'll never understand what he did for you. You'll never understand the price that he paid for you until you understand the great need that you have. You have a great need. You are guilty before God. It says, do not lie, and you broke the commandments of God. It says, do not steal, and you broke the commandments of God. I have. We all have. And we become guilty before God. It says, do not use the Lord's name in vain. And we break these commandments. Now, if you steal, and if you lie, and if you curse the name of the Lord, what does that make you? It makes you a blasphemer. It makes you a thief. It makes you guilty before God. We're all guilty, my friend, until you realize that you're guilty before the throne of God. That there's no way to save yourself. Until you realize that, you'll never be saved. You'll never, ever understand the good news. The law is a law to bring us to Christ. Galatians says, the law is a schoolmaster to bring us to Christ. The law shows us that we're guilty. And I know it's hard to understand and it's hard to accept, but you were guilty before God. The Bible says, don't lie. The Bible says, don't steal. The Bible says, don't commit adultery. The Bible says, do not use the Lord's name in vain. The Bible says, honor the Sabbath day. The Bible says that you should not curse the name of the Lord or use his name in vain. The Bible says that you shall have no other gods before me. And every single one of those commandments, you and I have broken. You broke them and I broke them. And nobody will get to the kingdom, God bless you. Nobody will get to the kingdom by obeying the law.
I forgive you then.
All right, God bless you. Nobody will get to the kingdom by obeying the Lord of God. Because the law is a schoolmaster. The law shows us that we're guilty. And you and I are guilty before God, a holy God, a great and holy God. You and I are guilty. And there's no way of dealing with that guilt ourselves. We need a mediator. We need a savior. But you can't have that savior until you realize that you're guilty. If you think you're good and you're righteous and that's going to get you into heaven, then you're sadly mistaken. Your righteousness is filthy rags. Your righteousness is filthy rags. Your righteousness isn't good enough. It will never be good enough because it's tainted with sin. It's tainted with disobedience. It's tainted with breaking the law of God. So all of us come short of the glory of God. Every single one of us is guilty before the law, before the Ten Commandments. And a holy God must judge. A holy God must judge. What courtroom, if you commit a crime and you go before the judge isn't going to listen to you if you've murdered someone and you say, oh, it was an accident, or oh, I'm sorry, oh, please forgive me. And he's going to have to judge you. And the law judges us. And the law shows us that we're guilty. The law shows us that we need his grace. And that's why Jesus said in his word, I give my life a ransom for many. That's why he said in his word, I am the good shepherd that lays down his life for the sheep. And if you understood that, you would know that Christ has shed his blood to save you from the wrath to come. That there is a wrath, there is a judgment, and there is a wrath of God coming. And every time we break the law of God, we are storing up wrath upon wrath upon wrath. And until we come to the blood of Jesus Christ for cleansing, until we come to that blood for washing, until we come to that blood and realize that blood was shed for us, we will never be saved. We will never be born again. That blood was shed for you, but only if you accept your responsibility to repent of those things that are dishonoring to Almighty God. There is an Almighty God who is wonderful and gracious and holy, who is the creator of all mankind, and he longs that you repent, and he longs that you would turn away from your sin and find the grace and the love and mercy of the gospel, that Christ died on that cross. The love and mercy of the gospel, that Christ died on that cross. And he longs that you would repent. But you have to repent, my friend, and find the washing of Jesus, the washing of the blood. The Christ shed that blood. He shed that blood that you may know his grace, that you may know his love, that you may know his mercy. He shed that blood to save you from hell. He shed that blood to save you from the wrath to come. He shed that blood so that you wouldn't have to go to hell. But if you continue to lie, then hell is your way. If you continue to steal, then hell is your way. If you continue to honor other idols but not God, then hell is your way. If you continue to curse the name of God and blaspheme, then hell awaits you and hell is your way. If you continue to dishonor the Sabbath day and dishonor your parents, then hell is your way, that you're storing up wrath and judgment upon yourself. You are storing it up and more as you reject the word of God and as you reject the Ten Commandments. The Ten Commandments show you that you should not lie, you should not steal, you should not commit adultery, you should not dishonor your parents, you should not dishonor God, you should not use the Lord's name in vain. These are sins, and as we break those commandments, we come under the guilt of God and we become guilty before his throne. But in his great mercy, he shed his blood to save you from sin and to make you righteous before him, to make you holy before him. He shed his blood to make you holy before him. He gave his blood and shed his blood to redeem you. And if you trust in him, you will be redeemed. And if you repent, you will be redeemed. You will be cleansed and washed and cleansed and know your forgiveness and know the goodness of God in your life. But if you reject it, if you reject the gospel, then there is only a hell that awaits you. There is only a judgment that awaits you, my friend. A fiery judgment, a fiery wrath for every sinner that disobeys the word of God. And every sinner that disobeys the commandments of God, then there is only one place, and that is hellfire. And hellfire is a real place. It's a real place, my friend, where every wicked person who rejects the word of God is sent. Every wicked person that rejects the word of God is sent there. And he gives you his life right now that you may be saved and born again and saved and regenerated anew with the Holy Ghost in your life and washed in the cleansing blood of Jesus, who'll cleanse you from your witchcraft, who'll cleanse you from your pornography, who'll cleanse you from your hatred, who'll cleanse you from your anger, a Savior that will cleanse you and wash you and deliver you and set you free today. A Savior that is real. A Savior that wants to come to you. A Savior that wants to save you. A Savior that wants to deliver you. A Savior that shed his blood to redeem you, my friend. That is the Savior that longs to bring you home to salvation today. That longs to bring you home. But you've got to repent and believe in him. You have to repent and believe in him. You have to turn away from that which is wrong and turn to him who loves and gives his life to redeem you today. Who gave his life to redeem you. Who gave his life on that cross. I give my life a ransom for many, he said. I give my life a ransom for many. He gave his life for you. He shed his blood for you and died for you. To redeem you from hell, to redeem you from the devil and his wicked ways, to redeem you from your own sin, God bless you, bro, to redeem you from your own sin, he shed his blood to save you today. And you can have that salvation, you can have that grace right now. It's free, you don't have to pay. It was given for you on that cross. It was given to you freely. Freely he gave his life, freely he died, freely he shed his blood. Freely he gave his life on that cross. It is a free gift for you, but you've got to believe in it and repent. You've got to repent of the old life. You've got to repent of the old life. You've got to repent of the old life and turn away from the old life. Turn away from witchcraft. Turn away from that which is evil. Turn away from that which is sin, that which breaks the Lord of God. And turn away and flee from it. Flee from it. Flee from lust. Flee from witchcraft. Flee from it all that's wrong. And flee to Christ. God bless you, bro. God bless you. And flee to Christ. And find deliverance. And find forgiveness. And find cleansing in his blood. Cleansing in the blood of Christ that can save you, my friend. That can save you. And bring you hope. And bring you joy. And bring you peace. Only in Christ, my friend. God bless you and have a lovely day.